Hi there. This is a song I wrote for anyone wondering what the heck permaculture is. I hope you enjoy. Permaculture design, just finished up my course. Wanna take it home, take the world on a tour de force of fruits and trees, flowers and bees, sprouts and seeds, enough for you and me. Yo, first come the earth, yeah, you got to take care of it. Then come the people, then each his fair share of it. Designed for the earth and you designed for yourself. Help design a world better for you and everybody else. Yeah, principle one, observe and interact, or you won't get far, man, that is just a fact. Principle two, capture and store energy, put the water in the ground instead of washing out the sea. Principle three, is often so, so tasty. It's obtain a yield no matter what you grow. It got to eat, to work, to live, to make it worth all the hoeing. Principle four, I keep you on track, self-regulate and accept feedback. By that I mean you got to know that things change. Don't be afraid to learn from nature's ways. Because first come the earth, yeah, you got to take care of it. Then come the people, then each his fair share of it. Designed for the earth and you designed for yourself. Help design a world better for you and everybody else. Principle five, it's better to be renewable. Hydroelectric, solar power, it's super doable. You don't need a tractor if you got a horse. If you got two hands, you don't need brute force. Principle six, waste is an illusion. Nature recycles all while we waste time in confusion. Principle seven, design for power.
I'm all about food security. Most people, most of the population live in neighborhoods of some sort. Talk about local, right outside your door, you got your tomatoes and your onions. And so our group talked about a lot of ideas and strategies for not offending people, but to get them to be open. And I have a whole list here. I don't know if you want me to read the list now, but that's mostly what we talked about.
Yeah.
Okay, these are some ideas from people in our group. Respect your neighbors. They have a different idea about things than we do. Start maybe with xeriscaping. Start small. Make your front yard visually appealing. Pass on your surpluses to your neighbors. Let your neighbors get to know you. Bring them, oh, here, I have some squash in my garden. Be nice, be likable, you know? And usually, we're more likely to complain about somebody who's a total stranger. But once you've met somebody, you know, you're starting to get to know, oh, that person's okay. And you have a different attitude.
Yeah.
It was suggested also to have edible landscaping out front, perennials in the front, pretty things like cranberry, hibiscus. Another fellow said contact your community before starting. And maybe have a potluck or something and talk about, hey, food security, you know, this is what we could do. This is my ideas. What do you guys think? A lot of people would like to get started, but they need advice. That's something we could offer. One thing, if we had some pictures of these beautiful gardens, like somebody went over to Jim's and took some pictures. And he's not the only one. His garden is like a work of art.
Yeah.
And say, here's what somebody else did, and you can show them. A lot of people think gardening takes too much time. Therefore, we have to demonstrate how easy it can be. When you have your no-till mulching garden, I know my garden is getting less and less work. I mulch, I plant, and I harvest. We have to emphasize low maintenance and set examples. And that was all our time.
Okay. Yay.